It's August the 6th, 1993. This is what this place, this town looks like after the waters went down. Water went all the way to the roof on that house. And there's the car that was completely covered. And there's the mud that's left over. They come and washed and swept our streets today. I'm standing in Gail's front yard, looking across the street and going on down the block as far as I can from here. There's still water sitting in places. This is Betty's house. You can tell by the awning how high the water went up there. Her garage door come up sometime in the water, so everything in there is ruined. You can see all the brown slime on the grass. There's debris everywhere. This is directly across the street from Dale. There's even pallets up in trees over on the other block. I'm standing right at the corner of 96th Street now. There's our mailboxes and there's some pallets. Was in the road, Bob and Inez's, what's left of their place. This is Gib Perry's old house, what's left of it. As you can see, it went all the way to the roof. Bunch of jumbled up mess there too. There's just boards and crap and junk and mud everywhere. There's Gail's brown yard. And there's our street sign clear up there. I ain't quite sure what it is. More debris. Still smells like a pigsty here. I guess they finally picked up their barbecue grill that was hanging on that fence upside down. This is just on our street alone. It was hanging upside down, hanging on that rose trellis. She had a beautiful patio set out here. We haven't seen hiding a hair of it. Don't know where it went. Floated off down the river, I guess. Part of that house, it's right by Gail. Even the porch is caving in. That truck there was under. Side of the house. This is what collected on that side, right by Gail. And this is what collected over here at Matthews. They got a real mess to clean up. Got everything in here. This is supposed to be an alley. Some more junk. Pretty good mess, isn't it? This used to be boarded shut. But as you can see, the water knocked it out and busted the windows. And this is Elm Street and Walcott Drive. There's that old store that was sitting on the corner. That van was completely under. Got up to the roof on it. Looked better under the water than what it does now. Didn't even break them windows though. It's odd. I'm looking straight downhill. Towards the elevator. Going towards the old bar. I mean, it is a mess. They figure these are all be condemned. You can see off there, it's not very damn far. There's still water. A lot of them still sitting there waiting to jump us again. That's where it come over last time, up there. Now this is the worst side of the tracks that got it the worst. Or worse, I should say, than what we did. They have been underwater for a total of approximately 29 days. A few houses down there, and every one of them's ruined completely. All the cars, the car's truck, that car, and every one of those houses, like I said, have been under for over 29 days. There's pallets up in trees and everything over on this street here. Be a very, very pretty green yard. All it is brown slime now. No, not brown, black slime. This is Walcott Drive. I'm looking off. Chewing on that damn tree again.
Lefty.